This is a continuation of our discussion of rendering using indirect illumination. And in this case, I want to introduce the concept of HDRI lighting and reflections. So there's another way to get indirect illumination on your scene that's not using these flat lights here. And so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to hide these flat light components temporarily. And so there's no illumination in the scene at all at this point. There's no lights. There's no flat lights with that constant shader to provide indirect illumination. What I am going to do is go up to Scene, Environment, and I'm going to say Select Environment Image. And there are a number of these so-called HDR images included with PhotoWorks. And what these are high dynamic range images that have wraparound photographs at a number of different exposures that have a lot of very intense lighting information in them. So they can actually be used to light up your scene. So let me choose the sky one here. And actually, I'm going to choose the daytime one. It has a more pronounced sun coming from a certain direction. So I'm going to open that up. Environment mapping you can keep as spherical because the ones that come with SolidWorks are designed for that. You can imagine your entire scene being enveloped inside a bubble that's actually infinitely far away from the objects inside the scene. kind of like the way that ancient people on Earth used to think about the sky as just a big shell out there that the stars were painted on. And think about this image as being wrapped on the inside of that sphere. But the image has it has lighting data in it, so the area where the sun is actually going to be very, very bright and is bright enough to actually illuminate your image. Now, the strength of that illumination is set by this slider here, this diffuse material brightness. I'm just going to keep that at the default for now, and we'll see what happens here. So again, all I've done is turned on that HDRI environment, and I'm going to go into the camera here and do a test render. And this is what I get with my test render. So a few things to notice. First, obviously the image is very blown out because the HDRI is way too bright. We can turn that down, though. That's easy. Also, there's some directionality here. You remember in that HDRI image there was a sun, and it's pretty clear that the sun is up here somewhere, casting a shadow this way. You also see that there's a blue color cast to the shadow, because the sky is blue in the HDR image, and it's actually that blue is carrying into the illumination. So let's go and back to our scene dialog and turn down how much light we're getting from the HDRI. I'm going to turn it about to half, and we'll see what happens here. And that's looking a little better, at least in terms of the contrast. We basically turned down the strength of the sun in the sky there, and we've got a much clearer blue cast to the whole thing, but we can at least see our object. Now, HDR lighting can be very nice. You're getting some nice diffuse lighting here, and if I was compositing this into an outside scene, this might be good. But you do get a few things like this color cast if it's not a completely neutral HDRI, and what's worse is that you can't control the direction you can't control the directionality of the HDRI image. There's no control for doing that in SolidWorks right now. What I'd actually have to do is rotate everything in my assembly relative to the origin if I wanted to change the direction that the sun appears to be hitting the object at, which is not a very elegant way to do things. However, there's also another use for HDRI imaging, which is in the reflections. Let me actually change the I'm going to change the material of our vessel here to just the regular polished aluminum, and I think by default it'll be polished aluminum, so I can just delete that so that we get some reflections here. And I'm also going to go in and change our HDR image to, let's use the kitchen image, which I think is often the default. OK, Okay. Notice I also have a slider here for environment reflections. And what other thing that HDR lighting gives us is nice reflections of that photograph off objects that we have in our rendering. So I'll leave it at here for now, and we'll see what we get. Okay, this came out kind of dark because that kitchen lighting wasn't nearly as intense as that sunlight HDR, so I can probably turn it up. But you can see that we've got some nice environmental reflections on our shiny object now, and if you look closely, it actually looks like the object is inside a kitchen. So that can be a very nice effect for trying to render something in context. To kind of take the advantage of the best of both worlds, what I will often do is I will use the HDR only for reflections and not to light the scene. So I'll turn the diffuse material brightness all the way down. I'll just leave the reflections there for now. And then I'll bring my plane lights back to do the lighting. So if we do this rendering, you know, now I've got the lighting in a much more controlled way because I'm using my plane lights, but I also get the benefit of these reflections from the environment. Now, obviously, one problem here is that we can see the plane lights reflected in the object here, and so you may have to be kind of creative as to how you place those so that it doesn't take away too much from it. Other renderers have the ability for these plane lights to be invisible to the camera or invisible to reflections. To my knowledge, PhotoWorks does not provide us that ability. So if the object can see the plane lights, they're going to be reflected in it by that. But, you know, so you kind of just have to balance your needs in terms of having more precise control over the lighting versus what kind of reflections you need. But it's good to know that you have both of these options in terms of indirect illumination of your object, in terms of either using these plane lights and or getting illumination from an HDRI image wrapped around a sphere that the whole rendering set is inside.